This is high school basketball on Frontier Community Access Television.
Goes around his man. Nice play by Ben Lowe. Lestoski on a runner is good. A running hook shot. Wow. Carry hook shot. Good. Warren pull up jumper from 12 is good.
Left side. Lowe will step up for three. Book it. Back to the right side. 3-point bomb. Put up and in. The dribble gets it back top of the key. Gilmore for three again. Good again. Left side. 3-point bomb. Put up. It's good.
It goes to Lowe. Lowe for three. Good.
On the right side, Miles Freeman from 19. Good.
Oh, Lowe, very deep three. He hit it. Whoa, that was way outside by Ben Lowe. Lowe, spin move in the paint. Off the glass and in. Pull-up jumper blocked. What a play by Lowe. Came over and just knocked it out of the sky.
High school basketball on Bear Country 95.3 tonight. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Turner's Falls High School, where now, finally, we get set for the Turner's Falls Indians and the Frontier Redhawks. Jeff Terrell and Bobby C. courtside here. Our studio producer is Dave Reno. A thrilling double overtime junior varsity game won by Frontier. That's why we're running so late. Boy, those younger kids, Bobby, put on a show. Now it's time for the main event. We got the Hawks and the Indians.
Yeah, and the best part about it was is that was like the pregame show right there, getting the kids all excited, getting the parents all excited for tonight's matchup. You know, these two teams are really two teams that are going separate ways. Looks like right now Turner's is on a real big roll. They're hot. They're having a great year. And Frontier, a little bit on the skids, but I'll tell you one thing right now. These two teams, they know each other. The kids have played with each other. You never know what can happen in any night. And Turner's Falls better not think that it's going to be a light journey, because if they do, they could end up getting upset right here in their own gym.
Yep, Turner's Falls coming in with a perfect 6-0 record overall. They are 2-0 in Hampshire League play. And as you mentioned, Frontier, a very slow start, 1-5 overall. Only 1-3 on the season in the league. But let's talk about the Red Hawks. Of course, last year's tournament team, they were 1-done. They lost to Mount Greylock in the first round, and they graduated just about everyone. Only one really returning starting player, and that was Miles Freeman, who began the year injured. He's now playing again, but they were decimated by graduation, so they're sort of retooling at this point.
They are, but they got a couple of guys that have really done a decent job early this year. You know, the guy that I've been pretty impressed with is Ben Lowe. Ben has really started off to a really good start. Thing is that Ben Lowe is, you know, he's a guy who's going to have to be one of their go-to guys that they're going to need to use for offense. One thing about Turner's Falls, Jeff, is that they don't really have a lot of great shooters. They just know how to be able to attack the basket. That's their big strength.
Yeah, and it's taken them to a perfect record so far. They want to keep riding this. They got a tough schedule coming up. They're playing some much tougher games coming up, including one next week that we'll talk about a little bit later on here, Bobby. But the bottom line is, hey, 6-0 so far. Gary Mullins has to be pretty pleased with how his kids have performed so far.
Well, you know, when you talk to Gary, and I had a chance to chat with him, you know, he said the one thing that he likes about this team is that they are a team. He said that these guys work very well together. A lot of these guys are a lot of the same football players that played for the football team. They're all here on the basketball court. It's nice to know that you can have a bunch of gentlemen that are on your team that really play that way. Team hoop.
We are getting very close to the tip-off here. 6-0 Turners, will they remain undefeated, or will Frontier pull the upset? We're about to find out. We're about 5 minutes away from the start of tonight's game. We'll take a timeout here on the pregame show. When we come back, starting lineups, national anthem, and the opening tip-off, Turners and Frontier, next on Bear Country 95.3.
First for the Redhawks, at guard, number one, Keegan Warren. Also at guard, number 15, Trevor Gilmore. At goal, number three, Ben Lowe. At goal, number 15, Miles Freeman. And at center, number 22, Carson Carey. And now let's hear it for your Turner's Falls Indians! At center, he is a freshman, their number 33, Anthony Peterson. At forward, he is a senior, number 24, Kyle Gordon. At guard, he is a sophomore, number 10, Tyler Gladden. He is a senior guard, number 23, Vicky Quigley.
Turner's Falls in their home white with the royal blue and black trim. Frontier in the visiting navy blue with red, scarlet red, and white trim. Steve Kreitz is our lead official. His partner, Billy Joe Robidoux. And it'll be Anthony Peterson jumping center for the Turner's Falls Indians. And the ball is in the air. The tip is controlled by the Turner's Falls Indians, and we are underway here from Turner's Falls High. 8 minute quarters with a 30 second shot clock. At the top of the key, Tyler Levin kicks it over to Peterson. Foul line right over to Craver. Left wing it goes to Tion Brown. Tion now will cut into the paint. The leaner off balance, off the window, no good, but a blocking foul called against Keaton Warren.
Like I was telling you, Jeff, one thing I have known about Turner's and I've been watching is that they know how to attack the basket, and that's exactly what Tion Brown just did.
And Tion's first free throw, however, is up. It is no good, and T will get one more here. Bounces the ball three times. Dips, shoots, hits. He makes one of two. 1-0 Turner's Falls. And now Frontier will come for their first offensive set. Keaton Warren takes it across the timeline. Looking for the cutter. He had Trevor Gilmore along the baseline. Couldn't quite get it to him. Throws over to Miles Freeman on the right side. Freeman to the foul line. Left side to Keaton Warren. Shot clock down to 10. Warren to the line, to the lane. They dump it down low. Gilmore trying to get to Parsons. Going baseline. Reverse lay-in is good.
Oh, that was a nice move right there against Anthony Peterson.
2-1 Frontier. And from the foul line, jumper by Tion Brown, rattles in, good for two. Turner's reclaims the lead, 3-2, 1 minute into this one. And bringing it on down, across the timeline is Warren. Passes over to Ben Lowe. Miles Freeman at the foul line, sealed off, they're trying to get it down low, tipped away. Here comes Tyler Levin, back to the way. Tyler's gonna take it right to the rack, lays it up and in.
Oh, they are fast, aren't they?
Transition bucket there. 5-2, Turner's Falls. Frontier able to break the press. Miles Freeman attacking the paint. Comes through. Can't quite get the roll, though. Anthony Peterson gets the rebound. Tion Brown, long lead pass left side. Craver, reverse lane is good.
Wow.
Nice move there by Ricky Craver. The reverse lane is good. It's another bucket for the Indians. They now lead by five. It's 7-2. Taking it across, Trevor Gilmore. Has it deep on the left side. Trevor taking the left side. Pull up pop from 18. Too strong. Weak side rebound taken down by Frontier. They get a new shot clock. Whoa. Deep on the right side. Gets it to Trevor Gilmore. To the line, to the lane. Dipsy to drive. Kind of flung it up there. No good. Rebound comes on down to Turner's Falls. Back the other way. Kyle Bergman gets it to Craver. Back to Bergman. Deep on the left side. Craver between the circles. And now Tion Brown gets it deep on the right elbow. Bounce pass into the lane. It goes to Tyler Lavin. And a foul on the floor before he can do anything. It's going against Frontier. Looks like that's going to go against Ben Lowe. And quick substitution for the Red Hawks. And Ben Liskoski checks into the lineup. Tion Brown inbounding on the baseline. Tyler Lavin all alone for three. And he drains it.
Wow. Nice shot right there by Tyler Lavin. And you know, losing Ben Lowe right now is really tough for Frontier. Already has two personal fouls.
On the left side, Listowski spots up for three. That's in and out, no good. No offensive rebounding for the Redhawks. Tion Brown gets the rebound. Frontier looks to run, but they throw it away. Warren comes up with it for Frontier. Warren passes deep on the right side on the wing. It goes to Miles Freeman. There's a kick on Kyle Bergman. So a new shot clock now for the Redhawks. They trail by eight. With 5:12 left to play here in the first quarter. Warren inbounding right in front of us. Looking for someone, having a bit of trouble. Finally does get it into Freeman. Freeman from 18, and it actually goes in, but it hit the wire above the backboard off the rim, off the miss. So they wave off that bucket. So even when they score, it won't count. So
I know it.
Tough offense to start for the Redhawks. We'll see if they can use some tough D to create some offense going the other way. The perimeter shooting hasn't been there. Deep on the right side, Tyler Lavin. He is double teamed, gets it away to Peterson. Peterson back to Brown. Tion Brown from the foul line. Tries to get it down low to Peterson. He does on the left block. Shot clock down to 10. Tried to feed the paint, got poked away. Back to Peterson. Brown now has it right of the lane. Forces one up with 4 seconds left. and that shot is no good. Tipped around, and it comes to Gilmore. Nice save along the sideline. Gets it over to Listowski. Ben, up ahead to left side. Keaton Warren in the corner. They dump it down low. Peterson looks to front, but Parsons able to turn around and hit. And here comes Tion Brown back the other way on the right side. Deep three ball put up by Craver, and he drains it.
Wow.
Ricky Craver knocks down the three, 13-4. Turner's Falls leading by nine. Warren is able to break the press, takes it up on the left side. Picked up there by Tion Brown, takes it between the circles. On the right side to Miles Freeman. Back to Warren. Plenty of time with the shot clock for Frontier. Warren working on Brown. Deep in the left side, Listowski. Gets it away. Open jumper from the free throw line. No good by Miles Freeman. Tipped around. It comes down to Peterson. Outlet on the left to Tion Brown. Takes it across the center court logo. Stops on the right wing. Flings it left side to Lavin. Lavin gets a screen from Peterson. Can't do much with it. Fade away Jay from the left side. In and out. No good. Frontier gets the rebound. Ends up in the hands of Warren. Keaton Warren will take it across. Looks like Croteau getting set to check in for Turner's Falls. Warren between the circles. On the right side pass, Listowski tried to feed the big man down low, got poked away. Here comes Tion Brown back the other way. He had it poked away from behind. It goes out of bounds. It'll stay with the Indians. And what do we got here? Timeout on the floor. We will take a 60-second break. 3:12 to play here in the opening quarter. It is 13-4 Turner's on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. 13-4 Turner's as Frontier off to a cold night shooting from the perimeter. So we'll see if they try to attack the basket more, try to get some better looks here.
Well, you know, the one thing that Turner's Falls has done a good job at is being able to work the ball. Everyone's touching it. That's a good sign.
And into the lineup, as we mentioned, Nick Croteau came in after that last timeout. He has it, throws over to Tion Brown on the left wing. Turner's Falls now spreading the floor a bit. In the right corner, it's Croteau. Try to get it down low to Bergman, tipped away, and it ends up in the hands of Warren. Warren takes it across the timeline, right corner it goes. Listowski for three, that shot off the back rim, no good. Carey gets the rebound, the leaner rejected by Peterson. Anthony jumping up and down, he thought he had a clean block, but he's going to get the personal foul call. And two free throws now coming up for Karsten Carey, just a sophomore. First one is on the way, it is good.
Jeff, he looks really good. I like this kid.
He's going to be a big part of Frontier basketball again the rest of this season and two more seasons to come. Second free throw is up. That one is in and out, no good. Comes down to Nick Croteau. 13-5, Turner's leading by eight. 2:40 to play here in the quarter. Bergman with Croteau back to Brown between the circles. Frontier playing a matchup zone right now. They go back to right side. Croteau with the leaner from three, a little bit short. Carey gets the rebound along the baseline, got it away nicely to Listowski. Warren throws it up on the right side. Coming through, unable to penetrate on the right side is Spencer, who just checked into the lineup. Warren has it. Slings it left side, Listowski. It's a screen from Freeman. Tried to do a pick and roll routine, couldn't able to come up with it, but Freeman picks up the loose ball underneath, flings it up there, no good. Put back up, no good again. And a nice save on the baseline by Craver. Got it away to Brown. Tion runs it up on the right. Turner's continues to lead by eight. Inside of two to play now here in the quarter. Brown to Craver. Deep on the left side it goes to Bergman. They're working beyond the arc right now. Shot clock at 15. Brown from the foul line shuffles it back to Croteau. Nick, jump pass on the right side to Peterson. He'll take a deep jumper, not really a shot. That is no good. And it comes on down to Spencer. Spencer got bottled up and now takes it across the timeline. Loses it right at center court. Ends up in the hands of Peterson. Tion Brown back for Turner's. Foul line left. Shuffle pass to Craver. Ricky. Jumper from the foul line. Partially blocked. Nicely done by Carey. Gets it up to Warren. Frontier in transition. Couldn't quite meet his man as he led Kyle Spencer too far.
Well, right now, a little bit of sloppy basketball at both ends, honestly. But we'll say one thing about Frontier is that they're not doing what Turner's is doing. They got to start passing the ball and try to find that open look, Jeff.
Ian Moriarty checks in for the Turner's Falls Indians. We have just over 1 minute to play here in the quarter. Turner's Falls leading by eight. Low scoring first quarter, particularly for the Red Hawks. Tion Brown splits the D, making things happen. He got fouled. The shot was no good. And that is the third team foul on the Red Hawks. Tian, they're going to say in the act of shooting, he'll go to the line. Tian shooting off to the left. And the first free throw is good. He will get one more here. Tian dips, shoots, hits. Turners by 10, 15-5. Exactly 1 minute to play here in the first quarter. Spencer poked away by Brown, trying to feed it over. It got Nick knocked out of bounds. He was trying to get over to Nick Croto. It's off of Miles Freeman. He'll stay with Turners. 28 to shoot, 56.1 on the game clock.
Good defense by the Indians.
Moriarty inbounding on the baseline. Gets it to Tian on the right wing. Between the circles, Craver, now Croto deep on the left elbow. Shot clock at 20. Brown, nice dish, put up and in, beautifully done. Booked the basket for Jimmy Vaughn. 17-5 Turners. Open jumper by Kyle Spencer, a little short on that one. And it comes down, a foul called against Frontier. The rebound came down to Nick Croto. He got bumped on his way down the court. He will check out of the Indian lineup. No, he will stay out there. Craver is now back in. And for Frontier, Jacob Meyer, just a freshman, checks in for them. 2 seconds, the differential shot clock to game clock. Another nice pass by Brown, hit Vaughn again.
Yeah, that was Hate, right under the basket. Great job by Jimmy Vaughn. And way to look for Tian. He's got a great vision.
And Ricky Craver knocked that one out of bounds, but they're going to get him on the foul, according to the official there, Billy Joe Robidoux, former Major League Baseball player, great athlete out of Ware High School.
Yep, just got inducted. A special tribute to him as part of the Massachusetts induction for sports.
15 seconds left in the quarter. Here comes Frontier back the other way. Listowski, the leaner, comes all the way through. Foul on the floor, so wave off that bucket. But a foul called against the Indians, and I think they got Jimmy Vaughn on that one. They did. And it was on the floor, so we're not shooting. 9.2 seconds left in the quarter. And who's going to throw in? Right in front of us, it's going to be Keaton Warren. Warren looking, holding, gets it in. Listowski fakes the three, picks up the dribble. They swing it left side. Spencer over to Warren. It's down to 3 seconds. Away to Spencer. 1 second left. They're not going to get a shot off.
Great defense by Turner's Falls. Nice job.
Did not let them get a shot away. End of one here at Turner's Falls High School, and the Indians off to a nice start. They lead at the end of one, 19-5 over Frontier on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. Second quarter action next on Bear Country 95.3. All right, Bobby, I thought Turner's Falls did exactly what they wanted to do. Tough D, some transition buckets, and they lead by 14 at the end of one.
Yeah, and nice. You know what I like about a guy like Tian Brown and a guy like Tyler Lavin is they both see the floor very well, Jeff. And when you got two guys that are running the point and they're able to, you know, have the off guard and the point guard being able to have good vision, look at the easy baskets Turner's has gotten here tonight.
All right, second quarter underway. Frontier with the ball. They have a new player in the game. We have to dip into the program here. He's not listed, so we'll identify that guy. We know that guy, Listowski, putting it up from the left corner. Ben misses that shot. And back quickly come the Indians after another one and done by the Red Hawks. Craver splits the D, comes through the paint, swoops, misses. Tian Brown there to clean up his shot, though, is no good from the top of the key. Rebound taken down by Frontier, and a foul called against Nick Croto as he bumped the Frontier player as he went for the rebound. All right, Frontier basketball as they head on down court. At the top of the key, the point guard swings it over. Pass batted down by Craver. Gets the return pass. Ricky swoops through, lays it up and in.
What a nice pass by Tian Brown on that play, Jeff.
Yeah, Tian's had a really fine night passing the ball. Hunter now coming back the other way. They go down low. Carey can't get the shot away. They go back to the right side. Three-point bomb put up and in. That is good for Trevor Gilmore. 21-8 Turners. That quickly. Back come the Indians, though. Teon Brown gets blocked as he headed down court. And a foul on the Hawks. Well, I'm trying to see if there's a 14. Well, they have their warm-up jerseys on. There's a number 24 out there. I'm not sure if that is 14, Kalen Evans, on our preseason program that we received. 21-8 Turners with the ball and the lead. Deep on the left side, Ricky Craver. Gets it over to Nick Frodo, deep on the left side. Nick, bounce pass back to Craver. Craver going left baseline, gets it to Teon Brown from the foul line. His jumper gets the kind bounce. It's just flowing for Teon tonight.
Yes, it is.
23-8 Turners. Quickly comes Carey, picks up the dribble, gets it back, top of the key. Gilmore for three again, good again.
Oh, that was nice.
Trevor Gilmore with a couple of trays, the senior. Gets his team back to within a dozen at 23-11. And Turner's has three players coming back in. Looks like Lavin Peterson and Bergman. Craver, three-point bomb put up, no good. Deep rebound comes down to Frontier's Ben Litskotsky. Up on the right side now is Gilmore into the left corner. Plenty of time on the shot clock. They work it around to the right side. Coming through is Carey. He is tied up. Picks up that ball, gets it left side. Three-point bomb put up. It's good. 23-14. The Redhawks now back to within nine. They are fighting back here. Very slow start, but the perimeter shooting has really picked up. Now the D is picked up. They tip it away from inside the paint. Here come the Hawks back on the attack. Deep on the right side. Gilmore, they swing it over. Left side, Lasowski going baseline. Finger roll, swoop through, no good. Scoop shot is no good. Couldn't quite corral it on the baseline. Goes back out of bounds. And now, as we mentioned, Peterson, Lavin, and Bergman in for Turner's Falls. Croto, Moriarty, and Vaughn will sit down, and we have a timeout on the floor. We'll take a quick 30-second break. 5:10 to play here in the quarter. It's Turner's Falls 23, Frontier 14. Now the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. All right, we are back here at Turner's Falls High. Indians leading by nine after that three-pointer by Alex Sharp. 5:10 to play here in the half. And we'll see if the Red Hawks can continue to stick around. They looked for a while there, with the lack of offense, that they were in danger of really getting blown out here, but they have fought back hard. All right, play resuming now. Deep on the right side on the wing, Teon Brown. Matchup zone defense right now by the Hawks. In a high post, they get it back, Bergman to Brown. Shot clock down to nine. Teon up fakes, turns, shoots, puts it up, no good, tipped around. Fight for the loose ball, out of bounds. It goes back to Frontier, a chance to trim the deficit a little more here. Lasowski inbounds the ball to Trevor Gilmore. He runs it up very quickly. Push pass down low, the leaner, and Meyer is blocked from behind. The putback no good. Battle for the ball, and we have a foul called on the floor here. It's going to go against Turner's Falls, and that's going to go against Anthony Peterson. Alex Sharp will inbound right in front of us. Just a ball from Steve Kreitz. They get it down low. And Carey turns, shoots in the paint, and hits. Nice play there by Karsten Carey.
Nice job by Frontier. Really starting to regroup as a team right now.
And they're now down by seven. Really playing some tough D. They're making it hard on Turner's. That ball got batted out of bounds. It will stay with the Indians, but they've been having a tough time the last couple of trips. Giovanni Williams checked in a moment ago. He's on the floor right now for the Indians. Deep on the right side, Bergman. Williams between the circles. Coming on through. A little shuffle pass back to Peterson. Shot clock now down to nine. Gets it to Teon Brown. Williams, shot clock at four. Over to Lavin. Teon Brown takes a three with the shot clock running down, and he drains it.
Wow.
Oh, Teon. They used every bit of that shot clock. The ball got loose, so they'll stop the clock here briefly. So that, at least for now, will stem the Frontier run. The lead for Turner's now back up the 10 at 26-16. Alex Sharp, double team, gets it away. Gilmore, a little shuffle pass over to Carey. And now a steal by Tyler Lavin, up ahead to Tion Brown. Tion all the way through, puts up a tough angle shot, no good, but he got fouled. And he'll go to the line for two. That foul is going to go on the other number 11 in this game, Ben Litskotsky.
Well, the reason why Tion Brown got a chance to go to the line is the really nice vision by Tyler Lavin to see him, and he just attacked the basket.
First free throw is good, so 4 points in a row now for Tion. And the Turners lead back up to 11 after Frontier trimmed it to 7. Warren and Freeman getting set to check in for the Hawks. Second one is on the way. That one is in and out, no good. And the rebound comes down to Carey. But tough pass, it got picked up by Lavin. Back to Tion, puts it up and in.
Wow, great defense by Lavin and saw the open man, Tion Brown.
Big swing for the Indians. They're leading now by 13 points and now looks like another turnover in the backcourt. Bodies flying everywhere and a good job getting the timeout. Nice play there by Trevor Gilmore. Another timeout on the floor. We will step aside, 3:18 to play here in the first half. On the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, Turners 29, Frontier 16. Jeff Terrell, Bobby C., Dave Reno with you here on this frosty Thursday night. Our halftime report is coming up, and part of the halftime report, I need to give you all an update. We have a final sign-up location in the Home Heat giveaway. And it's happening on Saturday in Greenfield. We're going to let you know where to go and when. Try to win that awesome prize coming up as part of our halftime show. Karsten Carey got stripped by Tion on the way up. Tion Brown, those quick hands over to Lavin. Lavin, a little jump pass, got tipped. But it comes down to Bergman. Kyle fights through, puts up the shot, no, but a foul. Tion Brown just is doing it on both ends of the floor. You have to account for that guy. 5'5", I don't care if he's only 5'5".
Doesn't matter. He has quick hands, plays great defense, and he also sees the floor, and he's a really, really good, really quality player. He just makes it fun.
First free throw is up, no good by Bergman. Kyle will get one more. And the second free throw is on the way. That one is no good as well. Freeman skies for the rebound. A little shuffle pass to Warren. Keaton Warren being pestered by Brown in the backcourt. And tried a little shuffle pass up ahead to Trevor Gilmore, but the pass went awry, mostly because of Tion Brown.
Tion Brown playing that defense that he's so good at.
2:52 to play here in the half. Turners by 13, looking to get a little higher. They're on a 6-0 run here. Williams on the right side. His pass is batted down, ends up in the hands of Warren. Warren takes it across. Pass it to Litskoski in the corner. They get it back to Warren. Back to Litskoski. Back to Warren. Back it out now. 20 seconds to shoot in a high post. It goes to Freeman. Left side. Trevor Gilmore. Three ball. That one's no good. Freeman the rebound. Works, worms free for the shot. No good. Comes down to Lavin. Tyler runs it up on the left. Gets it to Tion Brown. Top of the key. Tion got blocked by Gilmore, but the putback no good as well, and a foul. We're going the other way. It's going to go against the Turner's Falls Indians. Or do they just stay out of bounds? No, it was a foul.
They get Giovanni Williams, or?
I think they did get,
They did.
They got Giovanni Williams. Ricky Craver will come in for Williams. 2:09 to play here in the half. All right, inbounding on the baseline, and an errant pass got tipped around. Freeman's going to try to track it down, but it went way out of bounds. Back to Turner's Falls.
Boy, the defense for Turner's Falls has really started to step it up over the last 3 minutes after a very sluggish start in the second quarter, Jeff.
2 minutes to play in the half exactly. Turner's by 13, they have the ball. Tyler Lavin on the right elbow. Between the circles it goes to Ricky Craver. Tion on the right wing. Holds over his head. Now goes right by Warren. Nice little dish over to Peterson. Fights to a double team. Shot no good. Karsten Carey gets the rebound. Outlet on the right to Warren. Passes up ahead. Freeman wasn't looking for it, but Miles did get it. Down low. Oh, a big collision right under the bucket as Litskoski up faked on Peterson. And a foul on Peterson.
And
That could have been dangerous.
Oh, yeah. Big time.
Whew. Everybody okay, fortunately. And it'll be Ben Lisowski shooting right in front of us. First free throw is up for the junior. No good. He will get one more. Second one is up, and that is good. Quick substitution for the Indians. Jeremy Wolfram will check in. And Peterson now will sit with two fouls. 1:34 to play in the half. Turners by a dozen, 29-17. Tion Brown jogs it across the timeline. Whips the pass left to Craver, left corner. Goes to Wolfram. Tion has the top of the key. Down low to Wolfram, right side pass Bergman. Back to Tion for three. That shot is no good, though. Rebound picked up, but it was stolen right back. Ricky Craver, the leaner, left baseline. Couldn't quite get the roll. Blasting through. Wolfram puts it up. No good. Tip followed by Tion. No. And finally, the rebound to Listowski. Here comes Warren. Goes behind the back, between the circles. Stops there. He'll launch a three. It's good.
Wow, nice play by Keaton Warren. That was all Warren on that play.
And Tion Brown beat everyone down court and laid it up and in. Frontier did not get back. Now a steal by Tion. Puts it up and in.
Wow.
Four quick points by Brown. And Turner's back up by 13. Tell you, after that three by Frontier, the Frontier guys were kind of looking around, and Tion just went right down court. Nice pass. Warren gets it down low. Put up and in. Nicely done there. Miles Freeman with the bucket. Turners by 11. Shot clock off. 22 seconds left here in the half. Tion has it. They go. Pass tipped away by Freeman. He's got away from Bergman, but Bergman got a hand on it. Tion Brown. Another nice pass. Craver. Three ball. Bang!
Wow!
Brilliant passing by the Indians tonight. 7 seconds left in the half. Here comes Gilmore all the way through. He will lay it up and in with 2 seconds left in the half, and that is how the first half will end. End of the half here at Turner's Falls High School on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. It's the Turner's Falls Indians 36, the Frontier Redhawks 24. Stay tuned. Our halftime report coming up next on Bear Country 95.3. Bear Country High School basketball halftime report. Live from Turner's Falls High School, Turner's Falls leading Frontier 36-24 at intermission. Jeff Terrell, Bobby C., and Dave Reno as they get set for the beanbag toss at halftime. And we'll wait till that's over with, because you're going to hear a big noise in the crowd here.
Oh, yeah.
Are they ready to go?
Two, three, come on.
All right, they try to get it to the right, closest to the center. Last time we were here, Chris and I were here, and somebody got it right on there.
Wow, those are good tosses.
Well, there's a couple of weak ones, though.
Oh, yeah.
But
oh, yeah.
Most of them are very good.
Yep.
All right, speaking of very good, Turner's Falls 36 first half points. A couple of stumbles, and Frontier went through a stretch where they started to get their act together, but for the most part, Turner's Falls has dictated the tempo. It's been their game.
Definitely their game. And a great job done by Tion Brown and Tyler Lavin, two guys that I was expecting a lot from them in tonight's game, and they've definitely proven me right. You know, being able to not only put up 22 points between the both of them, but how about the fact that they've made a lot of the beautiful passes that have given other guys a chance to get in the scorebook, too?
Yeah, the Turner's Falls passing has been tremendous here tonight. Outside shooting's been fairly good. And they're definitely playing defense, which that's what they do. That's what they like to do. Very, very quick team. It has been a while now since Gary Mullins has had really tall guys. And we didn't mention on the pregame show, no Josh Obachowski tonight. He's not really the tallest kid, but he's, you know, gives them a little bit of height. But he's sick, not here at the game here tonight. It's amazing though, because the days of the Field brothers and some of the other big guys and. Summer Forest Bully,
yeah.
Guys like that. You know, it's been a while now since they've had those big trees. Uriah Forest Bully. It doesn't seem to really bother them until they get into the postseason. They play some really big teams. Then it's a little bit of a problem.
Well, it's funny that you said that, because I was talking to Nick Croteau's dad, and Missy said to me, he said, you know, right now things are looking good, but what about when it comes to tournament time? When you start seeing a couple guys from the Berkshires that come down that are 6'5", and, you know, they got the big body, who's really going to stop them?
Yeah.
It's a really good point, even by a dad who's already looking ahead to playoff, which I like that. I,
yeah,
I give
exactly.
him a lot of credit for that. But no, they got a really good team this year. And, you know, I think that what's made this team so good is the fact that these guys really do play together as a team, like Gary Mullen said. You know, they're not selfish. They really aren't.
On the other side, Bob, we talk about the Frontier team. Obviously, a lot of young kids. They graduated four of their five starters from last year. But I know that their head coach, Ben Barshefsky, you know, obviously you get excited when you have a team that has a lot of veterans returning, but that doesn't necessarily mean it's going to work out. Look at Greenfield right now. They returned a lot of kids from last year.
They're struggling.
They're having a tough time right now.
They are.
The other thing that gets coaches excited is when they have a bunch of kids that they can work into the rotation on the varsity level and see them develop over their freshman or sophomore years, knowing what they have for a couple more seasons. He's got some young players that look pretty good. He's got some JV kids that look really good.
Really good. And what I want people to understand about Ben Barshefsky is, you know, he's done a really good job with the athletes down here. After Gary Sanderson's big little brother ends up saying, hey, I'm going to call it quits. And now, of course, he's now taking over the girls' team now, Marty.
The girls program,
you know,
yeah.
It's funny because I'm looking at this team for Frontier, and the sad thing is foul trouble took out one of their best players in Ben Lowe, who really didn't play much in that first half and wasn't even a factor. But the one kid that's really stepped up for them and I'm very impressed with is Karsten Carey, doing a nice job down low. And what about that nice shooting by Trevor Gilmore? Made a couple of nice big threes, and he also picked up a nice transition basket as well.
Yep, so the Red Hawks did battle back when it looked like they were going to get blown out of this gym, but they do trail at halftime by 12. It's 36-24. We will take a timeout. More halftime coming up next from Turner's Falls High School. This is Bear Country, 95.3. All right, Bobby, we'll have you take a look at the halftime numbers before the start of the second half here.
Okay, leading the way for Turner's Falls with 17 first half points, Teon Brown with 10, Ricky Craver with 5, Tyler Lavin, and with 4, Jimmy Vaughn. For Frontier, leading the way for them with 8 points, Trevor Gilmore. Karsten Carey with 7, with 3 is Keaton Warren. Also, Alex Sharp came off the bench and picked up a 3-pointer. Miles Freeman with 2, and Ben Litzkowski has 1.
36-24, Turner's with the lead. They will have the ball now here to begin the second half. We are underway. Turner's now attacking the basket to our right. Teon Brown has it between the circles, calls out the set play. Splits the D, kicks it right side to Lavin. Back to Brown. Teon, foul line, over to Craver on the left. Ricky gets it back to Teon, shot clock at 10. Brown, double team. They whip it left side. Craver open for 3. It is short. Peterson gets that loose ball. Gets it back to Craver. Fakes the 3 that time. A little wraparound pass. Anthony turns, rejected by Carey. Gets it back, goes up strong. Turns, shoots, and scores. And you mentioned during the timeout.
I did.
Yeah, this could be the beginning of a rivalry between those two big men, Peterson and Carey. They're both young and skilled. Oh, beautiful behind the back play. Nice dish, put up and in. Miles Freeman on the bucket, but Gilmore with that nice pass.
Loved it.
38-26, Turner's by 12. High pass, pulled down by 11. They get it to Peterson. Pull up pot from 12 is no good. Battling for the rebound, and he gets it. But they're going to get him with steps.
Yeah, and he did such a great job, too. He knew exactly what he needed to do to follow that shot. He did, and he dragged his foot at the same time, Jeff.
Ben Lowe into the lineup. Was out with foul trouble early in this game. But he's out there now. A little scoop shot nicely done on the far right side there by Trevor Gilmore. And they turn it over.
Wow, hey, you know, Turner's got to get yourself back into this thing here. They started off the second quarter the same way they're starting off the third.
Teon Brown unable to make the connection. Warren will inbound to Gilmore. Fakes to 3, Trevor, nice pass over right side. Jumper good, open from the right side. Miles Freeman, Red Hawks to within 8. Teon Brown, top of the key, calls out the set play. Tyler Lavin in the right corner goes to Peterson. Guarded by Carey. Lavin for 3, bang.
Boy, that was a sweet shot by Tyler. That was all net.
So Otto, we've mentioned before, did not play football this past year. He's devoting himself now to basketball. Now a steal by Brown. Craver to Peterson. Puts it up and in.
Good passing right there by Turners.
Indians now lead by 13, 43-30. They break the press easily. Ends up in the hands of Miles Freeman. He puts it up and in.
Boy, it's really moving quick here.
43-32, Turners by 11. Peterson can't get away against Carey. Gives it up Bergman. His open jumper bounces around up there a couple, three times. Didn't fall. Finally, Miles Freeman corrals the rebound. Back quickly. Comes Keaton Warren. Going right baseline is Freeman. Miles picks up the dribble, gets it back to Ben Lowe. They work at left side. Three-point bomb by Warren. In and out, no good. Ends up in the hands of Peterson. Here comes Ricky Craver. Accelerates into the front court, stops there. Right side to Brown. Nice zips a pass down low. Bergman, no good. Got his man in the air. The foul will be called against Trevor Gilmore. And Bergman went flying after that.
He honestly looked like he enjoyed it for some reason. Just like laid his hands out like he was ready to do the angel.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. make a snow angel on the basketball court, yeah? Free throw is up. It is no good. And he will get one more. Bergman sights it, shoots it, and makes it. Turners by 12, 44-32. Lowe throws in, gets it into Carey. Carson's back, nearly batted down by Peterson. Peterson's just all over the court right now. Moves, very good for a big guy. Three-point shot is up, no good. Offensive rebound by Trevor Gilmore. Pass though, batted down. Here comes Ricky Craver, one on three, puts it up and in.
Wow, good hustle by Ricky Craver.
46-32, Turners now by 14. They're putting on a press, they get it into Carey. Poked away, but a foul called against Turner's Falls. So that's going to go against
Bergman.
24, Kyle Bergman. Timeout on the floor. We'll take the break. 4:40 out of play, third quarter. Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. Turners 46, Frontier 32. Back after this. And Turner's Falls will come out with Brown, Bergman, Craver, Lavin and Peterson. That's the same five that were just out there.
Wanted to bring something up to you, Jeff. You know, after the end of the first quarter, Frontier was down by 14, and really, them and Turners, the last two periods, have been playing pretty even basketball.
And a foul is going to be called against Ricky Craver. I believe it was Craver. We'll see who gets the ticket. Yeah, that's the second personal on Ricky. He was holding one of the Frontier guys as they attempted their inbound play. And they throw it in to Carey. Gets it over on the left side. Miles Freeman comes all the way through. Stripped on the way up, but it goes out of bounds off of Turner's. It'll stay with the Hawks.
Nice defense by Tyler Lavin. He got his hand in there to be able to prevent the easy bucket.
Warren will inbound on the baseline. Throws it out deep. Gets it in to Trevor Gilmore. Right side to Ben Lowe. Foul line jumper is up. And good by Miles Freeman. Got the kind bounce.
He's been hot here in the third quarter.
Turners by 12, 46-34. Teon splits the D. Nice dish to Bergman. Banks it home.
Nice pass.
He just has that great court vision. Knows where his four teammates are, and more importantly, the defense. Usually knows right where they are. Nice breaking the press by Frontier. They get the bucket on the other end. 48-36, Turners again leading by 12, so they're keeping them at arm's length. Three-point bomb put up by Craver, it's good. Ricky Craver knocks down the tray.
Yeah, he's had a good game today too.
We're halfway through the third, Turners by 15 now. On the right side, Miles Freeman from 19, good. These teams are lighting it up right now.
Yeah, this is a good time.
Fast pace and wow, does Teon Brown actually look winded?
Not really.
He got in the front court. He looked like he was breathing. Yeah, no, he is a little bit. I think. On left side, a three-point bomb put up no good by Craver. Out of bounds, right to Bobby C. And we're going the other way. Frontier basketball.
Oh, I was going to take the basketball home as a souvenir.
You should have. Long lead pass goes into Warren. And he takes it across the timeline. No, not yet. He's still in the backcourt. Does get away to Lowe, who got hit by Brown, but no foul call. Now there will be a foul call. That may have been a makeup, because I think Tion committed a foul, but instead, yeah, actually, they are going to post that against Tion, I believe.
Looks like they got Lavin, I thought. And Lavin's like, me?
Let's see. Yeah, yeah, it's on Tyler Lavin.
He went, me?
Lavin
I'm
said,
on the other side.
Come on, man. Michael Hollywood said.
Yeah,
come on, man. Out of bounds, and Frontier unable to get a shot away on that possession. Got tipped out of bounds off of the Hawks. Back to Turner's. They lead by 13, 51-38. 3:12 to play here, third quarter. Brown jogs it across the timeline. Top of the key. Passes left side. Lavin fakes the three. Bergman in the corner looking for some help. Back to Brown on the wing. Cross-court pass to Lavin. They dump it down low to Bergman. Fighting through. Can't get a shot away. Back foul line jumper by Brown is good.
Wow. Good ball movement by Turner's Falls on that possession, Jeff. They've been doing it all night.
A very good basketball team who has not lost yet this year. Looks like they won't either here tonight. Now another steal by the Indians, but Tion throws it away. It's up in the hands of Warren. Warren got bumped out of bounds. A foul called against Kyle Bergman. That was an easy call for Mr. Roboto.
Yeah, that was very easy.
Remember when Billy Joe, again, he comes out of Ware, big baseball star, obviously always a huge star in all sports out of Ware, but baseball was his sport.
Yep.
And I remember he got signed by my other favorite team. Of course, it's the Red Sox, but the Milwaukee Brewers. And he got to play with some of my heroes that I watched growing up. They go down low to Ben Lowe, missed from the left block, but he got fouled, and he'll go to the line for a couple. But Roboto got brought up in 1985. With the Brewers, and he got to play with guys like Robin Yount and Paul Molitor and guys like that.
Did he play with what was his Kingston? Who was that big home run hitter for the Milwaukee Brewers? Was it King?
Drawing a blank here, Bob, and so
might have failed. Might have failed. I might have failed. Kingman. Thank you.
Kingman was not a Brewer.
Okay, thank you.
He was not a Brewer.
All right. Just a little bit outside.
Second free throw is up by Lowe. That one no good. Tip follow, no. Tion Brown comes down with the rebound, so Turner's lead remains at 15 at 53-38. Jimmy Vaughn in the lineup for the Turner's Falls Indians. Down low to Peterson, who gets bottled up. A held ball on the arrow. It goes to Frontier.
Very impressed right now with the play of Miles Freeman. He really has stepped it up here in the third quarter for Frontier. Doing a great job on both ends.
Trevor Gilmore getting set to check back in for the Red Hawks. They try to get the Freeman that time, ends up to Carey. They get it over to Lowe all the way through. Got blocked on the way up. No, out of bounds. It's off of Ben. It'll go back to the Red Hawks. Well, actually, Steve Kreitz is going to, they're going to talk about this. And who's going to get the ball? They're going to give it back to Frontier here. So they overruled. And Gary Mullins is way out of the coaching box.
He's upset.
Way out on the court, which could get him teed up. They're not going to do it here. Spencer, left side jumper is short. Rebound comes down. Spencer, the leaner, misses that one. Foul on the rebound. And that's going to go against Turner's Falls. Nope, it's going to go against Frontier. It's going to go against Ben Lowe, his third. 2:03 to play here. Third quarter. Turner's leading by 15. Play now starting to slow up just a little bit. And the scoring as well. Brown has it out deep. They go to Peterson right side. His 12-foot jumper is good.
Nice
That's
job.
A nice roll.
Yeah, he's doing a nice job. He's really hustling, boy. He's all over the court.
In the backcourt, Spencer gets it away. They do break the press. Keaton Warren has it deep on the left. 22 to shoot, 130 on the game clock here in the third. Spencer down low, Carey going up against Peterson, traveling.
Yep. You know, I'm going to tell you, one thing I've learned about Peterson is he's finally, you know, putting his hands up the whole time and not using his body. Remember last year he had a lot of fouls against him, Jeff, that were body?
Yes.
Because he was still an eighth grader. He had a lot to learn. So that's just one good adjustment I've seen from him this year. Very impressed with him right now.
Pass batted down. Ends up in the hands of Tion Brown. Passes over to Peterson off his hands out of bounds. And it goes back to the Red Hawks. 1:12 to play here in the third. Peterson will check out. He's fun to watch play, though. He's very energetic on the court. He's got the big bushy hair. You know what he reminds me of? It's a different sport, but I remember getting back to baseball again. I was talking about Robidoux, but remember Mark the Bird Friedrich?
Oh, yeah.
And his teammates, an infielder would make a great play, and he'd run over, and he had the shaggy hair, and he was very all arms and legs. That's what that kid reminds me of a little bit.
Love that guy.
Lost him, sadly, several years ago. The shot up, no good in the paint. Miles Freeman, though, gets it back. Puts up the hook with the right hand out of bounds. Tips out of bounds. Goes back to the Indians. Lavin in. And Tion Brown will get a much-deserved break. He usually plays virtually the entire game.
Yeah. Hey, they got a chance to give him a break right now with being up by 17, so.
Under a minute to play here in the third. Ricky Craver, double team, gets it back to Lavin. Lavin has it between the circles. He's directing traffic. Throws over on the right side to Craver. Shot clock at 12, game clock at 28. Turner's leading. Biggie and Moriarty's out there now. Lavin top of the key. It's down to 5. Ricky Craver from 19. Air ball too strong. Comes down to Spencer. Kyle. Passes down court. Tipped away. Comes to Lavin. Down to 10 seconds left in the third. Lavin gets it back. Misses. Comes to Moriarty. Tipped out of bounds. It's off of Ian. Frontier will get it. 5.5 left here in the third. They're going to try to go the full 94 feet here and get a shot away. Into Spencer. 5 seconds. 4, 3. Spencer batted away. Craver at the buzzer for 3. No good. End of 3 here in Turner's Falls on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. Turner's Falls 55. Frontier 38. Fourth quarter action next on Bear Country 95.3. All right, fourth quarter underway. And Turner's Falls leading by 17. They have the ball. Tyler Lavin. It's the Moriarty. Nice. Ian couldn't quite finish, but a nice pass by Tyler. Miles Freeman zips up ahead that Trevor Gilmore hits. He put something on that pass. Turner's by 15. Lavin. Center court circle. Being guarded by Sharp. Left side. Croto puts up a 3. No. Gets his own rebound. Falling out of bounds. It went off the leg of Miles Freeman, who acknowledged it. And it'll go back to the Indians. And on the inbound. Going left baseline. Off the leg of Bergman. Throws in the backcourt. Or Jimmy Vaughn, rather, ends up in the backcourt. So, you know, I'll tell you, it's very different. I tell you, maybe I sing his praises too much, but Tion Brown off of the court, and it's a very different Turner's Falls offense.
I know, and it's funny because, you know, you got a guy like Lavin who really still is a really good point guard, and he does a good job being the general, but it's just not the same, like you said, without Tion in there.
Well, he's going to get a shot next year. He will be the point guard next year. Shot is no good by Frontier. Lavin, long lead pass up ahead. Craver got stripped in the way. I've tried to tip save out of bounds, but it ends up in the hands of Frontier. Listowski passes right side to Sharp. It goes to Miles Freeman. He's been hot. Misses that shot. Nice rebound by Moriarty. Gets it over on the right to Craver. Ricky runs it up. Push pass over in the right corner to Croto. Tyler Lavin, nice dish down low, put up and in by Jimmy Vaughn.
See, that's a nice work right there by Tyler Lavin. Vaughn wide open, Sam, right underneath the hoop.
Turner's by 17, 57-40. 6.5 to play here in the basketball game. JV, you're probably wondering if you're joining us now why we're running so late. Double overtime JV game, that's why. Win by Frontier. Red Hawks stored away, comes back to Craver. In the right corner, it goes to Croto. And unable to get the shot away, they go back to Lavin. Lavin now will work it back near the center court circle. We'll get guys cutting through the paint. They go back to Croto, steps up for 3, good!
Ah, nice shot right there.
Nick Croto knocks down the tray. 20-point lead, now Nick with the steal. But didn't have the numbers, it was 1-on-3, he peels back. Gets it back in the right corner. Nick, bounce pass down low to Moriarty. Goes to work, the leaner, off the glass, no good. Tipped. An attempted save out of bounds. It ends up in the hands of Alex Sharp of Frontier. Sharp will jog it across the timeline himself into the front court. He can handle the rock for sure. You can see that. Another young player. Going baseline, Miles Freeman blocking foul called. I think they got Jimmy Vaughn. They did.
Will that bring up the seventh team, or is it only six?
It looks like, I guess that's six. So okay. Not quite into the one and one just yet. Warren inbounding on the baseline, throws it out to Sharp. Gets it back to Warren. They dump it down low. Miles Freeman zips past right side. Lisowski for three, no good. Comes down to Lavin. Long pass up ahead to Craver on the right wing. Back to Nick Crowder. They work it around the perimeter into the left corner. Vaughn. They swing it back to Lavin. They set up the offense now with 18 seconds on the shot clock. 5 minutes to play in the game. Turner's leading by 20. Moriarty looking for the cutter down low. Doesn't have him. Goes back to Lavin for three. Good.
Wow, Tyler Lavin doing a nice job. He's really picking up his game.
Turner's leading now by 23. As it looks like Mully's going to begin to get some other guys into the game here. He's had this particular crew out there for a while now. Keaton Warren ended up losing it out of bounds as he was being pestered by Ricky Craver. So we have Wolfram, Williams, and Brown in. Moriarty, Lavin, and Craver will sit.
Yeah, a little line change going on there.
Turner's needs one more guy. Oh, no. William. Okay, what do we got? We got Teon, Williams. Now they need one more guy. They were playing with four. Lavin will stay. Lavin came to the bench. I'm thinking, wait a minute, guys, do you really want to play four and five? Teon Brown had his pocket picked by Warren. Swoops through. Reaching foul called against Teon Brown.
You see how fat, even getting the ball stolen from him, he still beat him back under the hoop.
Well,
unreal.
Well, what he's done with his his athletic career is that he's found out ways where his height has been an advantage and his quickness has been an advantage, and he just maximizes that.
Absolutely.
Free throw is in and out, no good. He will get one more. He has played his last football. That Turkey Day game against Greenfield was the last football game he'll ever play, and he was the MVP of that one. And basketball, he will probably be wrapping it up here. He'll be playing baseball in the spring.
Yep.
For Turner's Falls High. And then no more Teon Brown to watch anymore around
here.
No,
but curious what he ends up doing with himself. It'd be nice to know. He's a good student, too.
Free throw is good. 63-41 Turner's. Brown takes it across the timeline. Waits for his teammates to catch up. Tricky dribbles. Pass to Warren. Picks up the dribble. Bounce pass over to Nick Crotto. Had it poked away. Shot clock at 15. Williams, foul line right. Gets it to Wolfram into Jimmy Vaughn. Hits the leaner from the right block.
Well, you know, if you really think about what's going on here, Jeffrey, you look at the way Turner's has played, most of those 65 points are from right down underneath the basket.
Yeah, it's true. Ben Lowe on the right wing. Picks up the dribble. Was patted down Reese briefly. Three-point bomb, though, put up on the right side. That is good by Trevor Gilmore. Turner's by 21, 65-44. 3.5 to play in the game. Our post-game show coming up featuring the Helena Chemical player of the game. Teon Brown gets it back. That shot up and no good by Jimmy Vaughn. Keaton Warren will take it across the timeline at the center court circle. Top of the key stops there. Left side, Gilmore for three again. That's in and out, no good. He knew it. He tried to follow the shot. Vaughn, though, got the rebound. Gets it over to Teon. T will walk it across the timeline. Working on Keaton Warren. They swing it around. Jimmy Vaughn has it, holding it over his head. Deep on the left side to Williams. Williams will hand right back to Vaughn. They get it over on the right side. Down low, the leaner up, no good by Wolfram. And it comes down again to Trevor Gilmore. Left side, Low will step up for three, book it.
Yeah, boy, that's the first points of the night here tonight, Jeff, by Ben Low.
Good for three, 65-47, 18-point Frontier lead. And a whistle, a foul, and also a timeout on the floor. We'll step aside for a break. 2:31 to play in the game. And on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, it is Turner's Falls 65 and Frontier 47. But we still have 2:22 to play. Turner's Falls leading by 18. Nick Crotto passes to Jimmy Vaughn. Teon Brown has it. 7 seconds on the shot clock. He went through the lane, had it poked away from behind. Goes out of bounds. And...
Stevie Craig said it was the best call he made all night as the ball went rolling out of the building.
Deion Brown will throw in. He called out box, so they'll run out of a box here as opposed to the stack. They look for a cutter. On a back pick, they get it to Jimmy Vaughn. Foul line jumper rejected by Lowe. Clean block. Nice play there, but a pass thrown away by the Redhawks. 2 minutes to play. Turners continues to lead big. Teon Brown guarded by Warren at the center court circle. Tricky dribbles with him right on his hip. Nearly got it stolen away. Here comes Nick Croteau, double team. Jeremy Wolfram has it left side. Back to Brown. Shot clock at 12. Teon through the paint. Dipsy do drive. No, but a whistle and a foul. And it looks like Teon will go to the line here.
All right, looks like all the younger kids are all in for Frontier here.
And we will get to as many of those names as possible. I see Brandon Robinson has checked in. Saw his dad, Mike, a little while ago. Also out there is Nolan Graves. Ryan Olmstead is out there. They inbound the ball to Peterson, and he got blocked. He actually got fouled by about three guys, but only one of them will get the ticket. Still not shooting yet. It's only the fourth team foul on the Redhawks. Brown will inbound. They run out of the box. Teon's going to throw it out deep. Gets it into Peterson. Neil had it poked away by his own teammate. Nick Croteau now will have it. The head of the circle. Right wing it goes to Brown. Teon taking it in. Going baseline. And a foul on the floor before the shot. And that's still only the fifth team foul. So Teon will throw it again. And he calls out box again. He is waiting, looking for someone. Finally does get it in on the right side. Shot no good. Teon ends up with the loose ball, however. They'll kill some more clock down to a minute 20 to play in the game. Deep on the right side on the wing. Nick Croteau, shot clock down to 15. Jeremy Wolfram back to Croteau. He'll launch a three. That shot is short. Battle for the rebound. It came down the rims. He tried to save it. Ends up in the hands of Robinson. Robinson takes it across. Gets it top of the key to Noah Graves. Left side and a shot up and no good by Jordan Muzica. And Teon Brown has it for the Indians. Again, our post-game show is coming up. We'll see if we can get Mully and Teon over here, perhaps. Briefly, because we're running a little late here tonight. But maybe a quick word for them. Wolfram tried to bounce pass down low to Williams. Picked up. Muzica will swoop through. That shot is no good, but he got fouled from behind by Runes. He'll go to the line for two.
Yeah, nice hustle right there by Jared Muzica. You know, it's funny. I'm now living to where the kids that I coached in Little League are now becoming high school players.
Yeah. Yeah.
And we talked about Garrett Cody, and Mr. Muzica was also one of my players in Little League as well. So it just goes to show you that I'm getting old and they're growing up.
Free throw up and no good. 65-47. And they go to the foul line, and a jumper put up and no good by Luke Parsons. 18 seconds to play. They get the offensive rebound. Parsons has it right now. Gets it back to Robinson. Pass though picked off. Here comes Teon Brown. And he will get way up there and lays it up and in. Now he can't dunk it at about 5'5", 5'6", but he got up there. 3 seconds left. 2 seconds, one at the buzzer. Shot is up. It is no good. Turner's Falls wins it by 20. 67-47. We'll take a timeout. Our post-game show coming up next on Bear Country 95.3.